In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
奉主耶稣圣名,
peace to brothers and sisters alike who are worshipping together with us tonight online.
在此以平安问候,在线上和我们一起聚会的弟兄姐妹还有牧道朋友。
The Bible tells us that the Word of God is our food.
圣经告诉我们,神的话语就是我们的灵粮。
So it nourishes our soul and causes our spiritual lives to grow.
它滋养我们的灵命,让我们的灵命能够增长。
According to the scriptures, and the Word of God can also work effectively in our hearts, particularly for those who keep the Word in their hearts.
根据圣经也有说到，神的话语对那些守神的诫命的人而言呢，在他们心中是特别有功效的。
We want the Word of God to work within us effectively because we want to overcome ourselves, overcome sins, and also overcome the world.
我们希望神的话语在我们心中能够有效的工作，让我们能够战胜自己，战胜罪恶，还有战胜世界。
Many a time we find that we can be easily overcome by our own desire and the I that is within us.
那么我们常常发现呢，我们会被心中的这些私欲还有自我呢被战胜。
That's why we need the Word of God to help us to be victorious.
之所以呢，我们需要神的话语来让我们能够得胜。
Thank God tonight I'm going to share with you the topic reason with them.
感谢神呢，今晚要和大家分享的题目是与他们理论。
I want you to first turn to the book of Acts, chapter 17.
我们首先请翻到《使徒行传》第17章。
We read verse 2.
我们请看第二节。
Acts chapter 17, verse 2.
使徒行传17章2节。
Then Paul, as his custom was, went in to them and for three Sabbaths reasoned with them from the scriptures.
二节，保罗照他素常的规矩进去，一连三个安息日，本着圣经与他们辩论。
You find that this has been the practice of Paul, you know, whenever he went to a new area to preach the gospel.
那么这是我们发现呢，保罗到一个新的地方去传福音的时候呢，素常会做的事情。
He would first go into a synagogue or go into the synagogue in the local area.
他会到本地地方的犹太人的会堂里去。
And to preach to the Jews.
向犹太人来传福音。
So, you know, after he has done that, you know, he would go to the Gentiles to preach the gospel.
那么之后呢，他才会到外邦人那里去传福音。
You can see this actually quite often in chapter 17, chapter 18, and also chapter 19.
这是我们很常可以在17章、18章还有19章很常可以看见的一个事情。
So Paul would first, you know, go into the synagogue on the Sabbath to speak to the Jews.
那么保罗首先会到会堂里，在安息日的时候进到会堂里，来和犹太人说话。
When you look at the word reason, actually in the Chinese is like content.
那么其实我们看理论这个字眼的时候呢，在中文的时候呢，它意思其实比较接近辩论。
So we know that to reason means you need to like persuade, you know, like someone to understand your point.
那么若是理论的话呢，那么这意思就是说我们要用原因呢来说服别人。
Like you will gather, you will present your facts, you know, or to convince the person that you speak to.
那我们会呈现一系列的事实来说服我们说话的对象。
So you find that Paul, you know, he reasoned with the Jews that the purpose is very clear because he wanted to preach the gospel because he was preaching the gospel to the Jews.
那么保罗向和犹太人来理论的原因很简单，因为他在向他们传福音。
Many Jews or Jewish people did not believe that, you know, Jesus is the Savior.
那么有很多的犹太人不相信说耶稣就是救主。
And therefore, Paul has to convince them, you know, with reasons based on the Bible.
那么保罗就需要用本着圣经的这些理由来说服他们。
So likewise, when we preach a sermon, when we speak a sermon, you know, in order to make our sermon effective and useful to the listeners, we have to base our sermon on the scriptures.
那么在我们在讲道的时候呢，我们若是要听者能够得到造就的话呢，那我们的讲道一定是要本着圣经来说。
Because we believe that, you know, our message must be Bible-based.
因为我们相信我们的信息是需要有圣经的根据的。
So in a worship setting, you know, whatever we speak, we hope that our words can be in line with the teachings of the scriptures.
那么在崇拜这个情况的时候，那我们就希望我们所说的呢，就是有圣经的根据。
So we do not want to speak our own words, but rather we want God. We want to speak God's words.
那我们所要说的不是自己的话语，而是要说出神的话语来。
So you know, in many cases, we would want the Bible or the scriptures to speak for itself.
那么很多时候，我们就要圣经来为自己说话。
Now I want you to look at verse 2 again. Yeah.
我们请再看第二节。
Here it says a poor reason with obviously the Jews from the scriptures.
那么这里告诉我们说保罗是本着圣经与犹太人来理论。
I guess we always hear members or even workers say that we must always go back to the scriptures.
那我们很常听见信徒还有工人都对我们说要回到圣经来。
I guess this is a very important concept to understand.
那这是我们需要明白的一个关键的概念。
So when we try to present a message, we have to make sure that it is from the scriptures.
那若我们若是要传达某个信息的时候，我们要确保它是有圣经的根据的。
So I guess you know, many of us would always use the Bible to back up, for example, our sermons or our message or messages to our truth-seeking friends.
我们会确保我们所讲的道呢是有圣经，就像慕道朋友来传道的时候呢，会有我们所说的是有圣经的根据的。
There is a question we need to ask.
但是有一个问题我们是要问自己的。
How exactly can we go back to the scriptures and what exactly does it mean?
那我们要怎么回到圣经去呢？这是什么意思呢？
For example, if you do not know about the, you know, there is only one God.
例如说，我们要是不晓得只有一位独一真神的话呢
？How are you going to use the scriptures, you know, to talk about God?
那我们要如何用引用圣经来谈论神呢？
Probably, you know, when you use the scriptures to talk about God, you know, your idea may not be perfect, may not be completely in line with.You know, the overall concept of the church concerning the one God.
那我们若是这样的话，我们若是用这圣经来谈论神的话呢，那我们可能不会提及到圣经里宏观这个有关于神的概念。
Because you were not taught, you know, properly the one God and who this one God is.
因为我们没有被正确的教导有关于这位独一的真神究竟是什么。
So you find that when we talk about using the scriptures as our basis,
那我们若是说我们若是要用圣经来做我们的底的话呢？
We must not rule out the basis that the condition that we must first be taught the right way of salvation.
那我们不能排除我们要被这首先是要被教导有关于这救恩正确的道路。
I want you to look at the next verse, yeah, verse 3.
我们请看下一节，就是第三节。
To look at very closely, you find that, you know, Paul used the scriptures to explain concerning who the Lord is, who Jesus is.
那这里告诉我们，保罗很清楚地用圣经来讲解成名基督是谁。
I want you to read verse 3.
我们请看第三节。
Explaining and demonstrating that the Christ had to suffer and rise again from the dead, and saying, "This Jesus, whom I preach to you, is the Christ."
三节，讲解成名基督必须受害，从死里复活，又说，我所传的你们，我所传于你们的这位耶稣就是基督。
Where did Paul get this idea from?
那保罗这个概念是从哪里得到的呢？
Obviously, when you read the book of Galatians, we are told that he was inspired by God to understand, you know, the gospel of God.
那如果我们若是读加拉太书的话呢，我们发现他是被神来启发，有关于这件事情。
So you see that the apostles talk about this.
那么我们可以看见使徒也有在谈论这件事情。
I want you to look at chapter 2.
我们请看第二节。
Chapter 2. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2.
使徒行传第二章。
We read verse 36, yeah? 36.
我们请看三十六节。
Acts of the Apostle, chapter 2, verse 36.
使徒行传二章三十六节。
Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God has made this Jesus, whom you crucified, both Lord and Christ.
故此，以色列全家当确实的知道，你们钉在十字架上的这位耶稣，神已经立他为主，为基督了。
This is the message, a part of the message of Peter on the day of Pentecost.
那么这是彼得在五旬节当时的他的信息的其中一部分。
So when the Spirit came upon them, you know, Peter later on stood up to preach a sermon to the doubters.
那么当神的灵降在他们身上的时候，彼得就起来来讲道。
And he spoke to those who were mocking at the times.
那么他就向那些讥笑他们的人来讲道。
To confirm to them that, you know, this Jesus is the one whom they crucified. Now God has ordained him to be both the Lord and Christ.
那么他就向他们证实说他们在十字架上他们钉在十字架上的这位耶稣呢，神已经立他为主，为基督了。
Now, when you look at the Gospel of Luke,
那我们看路加福音的时候呢
，Chapter 24,
24章。
We can turn to Chapter 24.
我们可以看路加福音24章
，Verse 46,
46节。
This is the message, you know, preached by Jesus to his apostles, to his disciples, right before his ascension.
那么这是耶稣向他的门徒、他的使徒在他升天以前向他们所传的信息。
So before that, Jesus opened their understanding to know the scriptures.
那么之前呢，耶稣就开启他们的心，来让他们能够来明白圣经。
So that they can fully understand who this Christ was.
让他们能够明白这位基督是谁。
And to help them understand that it was necessary for Christ to come to suffer in order to accomplish the work of salvation.
让他们了解说，基督必须来受害，来让救恩能够成全。
We understand that the apostle or the disciples were with Jesus for about 3 years.
我们了解呢，使徒和门徒呢和耶稣在一起，大约有3年的时间。
We know that from the Gospel of Mark, yeah, you know, and Jesus repeatedly told them about his own suffering.
那么从马可福音当中呢，我们发现说耶稣不断的向他们提起他所要受的苦。
For example, in chapter 8 of Mark, verse 31.
例如说在马可福音8:31。
And here Jesus predicted his own death and his own resurrection.
那么这里耶稣就预言了他的死还有他的复活。
You know, when Jesus told them about his own death and his own resurrection.
当耶稣向他们提起他的死还有他的复活的时候呢？
These words actually caused Peter to rebuke Jesus Christ.
那么他所说的这番话语呢，让彼得来责备他。
So Jesus has to correct him at the time.
那么当时耶稣就来将他改正过来。
Now when you come to chapter 9,
那我们来到第九章的时候呢？
Again, you see that they did not understand, you know, what Jesus had said to them.
那我们看见他们不了解，耶稣所向他们说的是什么意思？
Concerning his suffering and his death.
这是有关于他的死，还有他的复活。
We can see this actually, from verse 31 to verse 32.
这是从31节到32节。
And Jesus again spoke to them the third time in chapter 10.
那么耶稣在第十章又第三次向他们说话。
We can see this in verse 32 and also in verse 33.
这是32到33节。
So you know, again, they did not understand.
那么再一次的，他们是不了解这番话的。
Jesus has been telling them about the scriptures concerning his own suffering.
那么，耶稣是就照着圣经来向他们说有关于他所要受的苦。
So after his resurrection, Jesus has to teach them.
那么在他复活以后呢，耶稣有必要来教导他们。
Teach them concerning matters. You know, concerning the kingdom of God.
那么教导他们有关于神的国。
And yet you find that they did not understand. Only when Jesus opened their understanding, and then they began to comprehend.
那么起初他们是不了解的，却是要在耶稣开启他们的心之后，他们才能够了解。
So when the Spirit came upon them on the day of Pentecost.
所以在五旬节当圣灵降在他们身上的时候
，You find that the apostles, yeah, and then later on those who came to believe were able to reason, you know, the suffering, the death of Jesus with the scriptures.
那么我们发现说使徒还有之后相信的人呢，都能够借着圣经呢来理论耶稣所受的难，耶稣的受难。
When we say, you know, when we talk about the gospel of salvation, we have to go back to the scriptures.
所以当我们谈论到得救的福音的时候呢，我们一定要回到圣经去。
What exactly does it mean?
所以这意思究竟是什么呢？
First, we must not deviate from what we have received.
那么首先呢，我们不能偏离我们所从我们所领受的来偏离。
Because you know what we have received is like you know a beam of light to us.
因为我们所领受的对我们来说就像一道光。
We can see it very clearly.
我们很清楚的能够看见。
We see the gospel clearly through our faith in the gospel, through our belief in the gospel.
那么我们接着对我们对于福音的这信心呢，我们能够很清楚的看见。
And because of that, we can use the scriptures to reason out, to talk to our friends, concerning the gospel of salvation.
那这让我们能够本着圣经呢，来向我们的慕道朋友来谈论有关得救的福音。
So we need to bear this in mind very clearly.
那我们要谨记这一点。
To use the scriptures is commendable, is very important.
那么能够来引用圣经呢，是值得嘉许的，是非常重要的。
That does not, give us the reason for us to deviate from what we have received.
那这却不会给我们理由来偏离我们之前所领受的。
Now, you'll find that only with what we have received, the gospel light that we have received will enable us to see, the gospel even more clearly than before.
那只有借着我们根据我们之前所领受的来让我们看见这光的福音，让我们能够来正确的来理论这个福音。
Now, I just want to give you an example.
那我在这里举一个例子。
We turn to Acts of the Apostle, chapter 18.
我们请看《使徒行传》第八章。
We can read from verse 24.
我们可以从24节开始念起。
Chapter 18, verse 24.
十八章二十四节。
Now a certain Jew, the name Apollos, born in Alexandria.An eloquent man and mighty in the scriptures that came to Ephesus.
四节有一个犹太人名叫亚波罗，来到以弗所。他生在亚历山大，是有学问的，最能讲解圣经。
I guess we all know this person, from the scriptures. Apollos was a man mighty in the scriptures, according to the descriptions given here.
那我们应该都很熟悉这位人物，就是最能讲解圣经的亚波罗。
But you find that actually he was ignorant of baptism in the name of Jesus.
但是他对于以耶稣的名来受洗的这件事情上呢是无知的。
So you find that later on he was corrected.
那么之后呢，他是有被改正过来的。
We read verse 25.
我们请看二十五节。
This man had been instructed in the way of the Lord, and being fervent in spirit, he spoke and taught accurately the things of the Lord, though he knew only the baptism of John.
二十五节，这人已经在主的道上受了教训，心里火热，将耶稣的事详细讲论教训人，只是他单晓得约翰的洗礼。
Let's think about this. Yeah, he knew the scriptures. He can explain the scriptures according to the record here accurately.
那么他，我们仔细想想，他是了解圣经的，是能够将耶稣的事详细的讲论。
The question is, can his message at that time save those who listen to him?
那问题就是说，他当时所传的信息呢，是否能够让听见的人得救呢
？Because according to the Bible, he only knew the baptism of John.
因为根据圣经的记载呢，他只单晓得约翰的洗礼。
So you find that later on, this couple here, Aquila and Priscilla, help him to understand the correct baptism.
那么之后呢，我们发现有位夫妇，就是百基拉和亚居拉呢，就帮忙改正他，让他能够来了解正确的道理。
A way to read verse 26.
我们请看二十六节。
And so he began to speak boldly in the synagogue. When Aquila and Priscilla heard him, they took him aside and explained to him the way of God more accurately.
二十六节，他在会堂里放胆讲道。百基拉、亚居拉听见，就 借他来将神的道给他讲解，讲解更加详细。
Now, I want you to look at verse 27, 28 as well.
那么也请看27还有28节。
When he desired to cross to Achaia, the brethren wrote exhorting the disciple to receive him, and when he arrived, he greatly helped those who had believed through grace.
27节，他要想要往亚盖亚去，弟兄们就勉励他，并写信请门徒接待他。他到了那里，多帮助那蒙恩信主的人。
Now verse 28.
28节。
For he vigorously refuted the Jews publicly, showing from the scriptures that Jesus is the Christ.
在众人面前极有能力驳倒犹太人，引圣经证明耶稣是基督。
Now, judging from this passage, we understand that Apollos was taught not the the complete gospel.
那么从这一段经节，让我们了解呢，亚波罗所被教导的不是完全的福音。
Later on, he came to understand the complete gospel of salvation through Aquila and Priscilla.
之后呢，他是借着百基拉和亚居拉呢，能够来了解这全备的福音。
So you find that you know the he used the scriptures to prove that Jesus is the Christ.
那么这里告诉我们，他引圣经证明耶稣是基督。
Again, you know, the purpose for him to use the scriptures is very clear.
那么这里呢，他引用圣经的目的是明确的。
To prove that Jesus is the Christ.
这是要证明耶稣是基督。
So the Paul proved that Jesus is the Christ based on the scriptures.
那么保罗是借着圣经来证实耶稣是基督。
And the other apostles also used the scriptures to prove that Jesus is the Christ.
那么其他的使徒也是引用圣经来证明耶稣是基督。
So you find that they share this the same belief.
那这让我们知道说他们拥有同样的信仰。
That is Jesus is the Christ.
就是耶稣就是基督。
And this is what they have been taught from the very beginning when Jesus was with them before his ascension.
那么这是耶稣在他升天以前起初所教导他们的。
So the point I'm trying to bring to your attention is that when we go back to the scriptures to study the scriptures more, and we need to understand that that does not warrant us to depart from what we have received initially.
那我所要着重的这一点呢，就是我们当我们来引用圣经来更加的来查考圣经的，来更加明白圣经的时候呢，这不能让我们来这不代表我们能够来偏离我们起初所领受的。
In fact, you know, the more we hold on to the initial belief, the more understanding we shall gain from the scriptures.
那么我们要是越抓将起初所领受的抓得越紧的话呢，那我们能够更加的来明白圣经。
In fact, you know, we are able to understand many aspects of the mystery of God, based on the Bible.
那我们是能够根据圣经来更加的了解神的奥秘。
Okay, now I want you to move on. We turn back to chapter 17.
那我们接下来看十七章。
You find that later on, Paul went to Berea.
那我们发现保罗来到比利亚这个地方。
He also preached the gospel to them, and he immediately, you know, he went into the synagogues and he preached to the Jews.
那他到了那里的时候，就进入犹太人的会堂来向他们传道。
I want you to read verse 11.
我们请看十一节。
Chapter 17, verse 11, these were more fair-minded than those in Thessalonica in that they received the word with all readiness and searched the scriptures daily to find out whether these things were so.
十一节，这地方的人咸于帖撒罗尼迦的人，甘心领受这道，天天查考查考察圣经，要晓得这道是与不是。
Paul came to Berea to preach the word to the Berean.
那么保罗来到比利亚，向当地的人来传道。
So here we are told that you know they were more noble-minded than those in Thessalonica.
那么这里告诉我们了，这地方的人咸于帖撒罗尼迦的人。
Meaning that they were very kind people or genuine people who would search into you know the truth that they had heard from Paul.
那么这里告诉我们，就是当地就有很多很真实的人呢，就愿意来考察圣经。
How did they you know go about finding out what they have heard is correct or not?
那他们是怎么来晓得这道是与不是呢？
They use the scriptures.
他们就是引用圣经。
So the script, the word of God, the right way of salvation was first preached to them.
那么神的话语，救恩正确的道路呢，首先是传给他们的。
Because what the apostle preached obviously is accurate, is from God.
那么使徒传的当然是正确的，因为是由神那里来的。
So when this, you know, Berean listeners search into the scriptures.
所以当比利亚的人来考察圣经的时候呢？
Obviously, they could find, you know, the proof or confirmation from the scriptures concerning the truth that they have heard.
那么他们就能够找到有关于他们所听见的这真理。
So in verse 12, it says, many therefore believed.
所以十二节告诉我们他们中间都有相信的。
So you find that, you know, the message must first be preached to them.
那么发现说呢，这信息首先是要传给他们。
And then they use the scriptures, yeah, to back up what they have heard.
那么他们之后呢，是引用圣经来证明他们所听见的。
Obviously, through the work of the Holy Spirit, they came to believe.
当然是借着圣灵的工作呢，他们就来相信。
So without the message from Paul, you know, no matter how they search the scriptures, they would not have known the right way of salvation.
那么要是没有保罗向他们所传的信息呢，不论他们是多么努力的来考察圣经呢，他们是不能够来了解的。
So I guess, you know, we need to understand this very well because we have first been given, you know, the pattern of sound word.
那我们要了解的是说我们首先是被给予这道理纯正的规模。
With this patterns of sound word, then we can search into the scriptures more and more, and we'll receive more understanding from God, particularly concerning the word of salvation.
那么有了这道理纯正的规模，我们能够来更加的来考察圣经，让我们能够更加的来了解我们的救恩。
Now, you find that in this chapter, later on, Paul went to Athens.
发现说接着在这一章就提到说保罗到雅典去。
He first again went to the synagogues to preach to the Jews, as we can see in verse 17.
我们首先在十七节也可以看到他又是再一次的首先到了会堂里向犹太人来传道。
We read verse 17.
我们请看十七节。
And therefore he reasoned in the synagogue with the Jews and with the Gentiles worshippers and in the marketplace daily with those who happened to be there.
十七节，于是在会堂里与犹太人和近前的人，并每日在世上所遇见的人辩论。
Now what did Paul reason with them about?
那保罗与他们来理论的是什么呢？
Now, if you look at verse 18, this is what you know the people there you know said.
我们看十八节的就可以看见当地的人所说的是什么。
He preached to them Jesus and the resurrection.
那么保罗向他们传讲耶稣与复活的道。
So you find that this is the theme that Paul would always preach, would always talk about to you know, the Jews and the Greek alike.
那么这我们会发现到，这是保罗所向犹太人还有希腊人时常所传的道。
Now later on, you know, he was in this place called Areopagus. In verse 22,
发现到他到在二十二节就到了亚略巴谷这个地方。
So he spoke to the Athenians, yeah, concerning God.
那么他就向雅典人谈论神。
We know that these people that did not believe in Jesus, in fact, they believe in many other gods.
我们知道说这些人都不相信耶稣，反倒是相信各种各样的神。
So you find that when Paul talked to them about God, yeah, he did not, you know, deviate from the key points that Jesus has instructed his disciple to do, to preach.
那么他向他们讲论的时候呢，他没有偏离耶稣所要他们所传的这个最关键的信息。
The point I'm making is that, you know, when he reasoned with these people, you know, he reasoned, you know, his foundations for his reasoning is on, you know, the truth that he has received from Jesus.
关键就在于他向他和他们理论的时候，他所说的还是根据他起初所领受的。
Now, if you read the verse 30,
我们看三十节。
And we also can read the verse 31 as well.
我们也请看三十一节。
Truly, these times of ignorance, God overlooked, but now commands all men everywhere to repent. Verse 31, because he has appointed a day on which he will judge the world in righteousness by the man whom he has ordained, he has given assurance of this to all by raising him from the dead.
三十节，世人蒙昧无知的时候，神并不监察，如今却吩咐各处的人都要悔改。三十一节，因为他已经定了日子，要借着他所设立的人按公义审判天下，并且叫他从死里复活，给万人做可信的凭据。
We know that when we read the Gospel of Luke chapter 24.
我们知道呢，我们读路加福音二十四章的时候呢
，the key messages, you know, about Christ's death and resurrection, and repentance and the remission of sin.
那么主要的信息就是基督的死和复活，还有罪的赦免，悔改和罪赦罪。
So you find that Paul, you know, did not deviate from that.
那么保罗没有偏离这样的道理。
He was trying to prove to them, yeah, who the Lord is.
他在向他们证明主究竟是谁。
He used reasoning, his own reasoning, to prove, to confirm to them.
他用他自己的一番理论来证明他所说的。
But his reasons are based on what he has received.
但是他的理论呢，是根据他所领受的。
Meaning that when we preach the gospel, even when we try to introduce a God, yeah, to an atheist or someone who does not believe in Jesus.
意思说呢，我们在传福音的时候，要是我们像例如说无神论的人来来介绍来向他们介绍神的时候呢
，we must always mention the main points of salvation, that is Jesus Christ, the Savior.And his death and resurrections, and the remissions and the forgiveness of sin.
那我们一定要提到救恩的重点就是耶稣的死和复活悔改还有受洗。
So, and these are the key points that we must always mention.
那这是我们一定要提到的一些重点。
We always talk about the movement of the Holy Spirit in our work, in our preaching.
那么常常会提到说圣灵会在我们的 工作还有传福音当中来感动我们。
But we need to understand that even when a person is moved by the Holy Spirit, you know, and to reason, yeah, with others, you find that, you know, his reasoning will not be away from the core belief, yeah, that he has received.
那当一个人被圣灵感动来与他人理论的时候呢，我们会发现到他所理论的不会偏离，他所领受的。
I want to read chapter 18.
我们请看十八章。
We read first Acts chapter 18. We read from verse 4.
十八章我们请看第四节。
And he reasoned in the synagogues every Sabbath and persuaded both Jews and Greeks. Verse 5, when Silas and Timothy had come from Macedonia, Paul was compelled by the Spirit and testified to the Jews that Jesus is the Christ.
四节，每逢安息日，保罗在会堂里辩论，劝化犹太人和希腊人。五节，希拉和提摩太从马其顿来的时候，保罗为道迫切，向犹太人证明耶稣是基督。
In the English version, the phrase says he was compelled by the Spirit.
那么在英文圣经里有提到说他是被圣灵所被使得变得迫切的。
So in the Spirit, he was compelled, you know, to talk about Jesus.
那么在灵里呢，他是被圣灵来感动，要来。
So he has been reasoning, you know, he has been reasoning with the Jews for many Sabbaths in the synagogues.
那么他在会堂里呢，已经花了好几个安息日来劝化犹太人。
So when Silas and Timothy came, he was compelled by the Holy Spirit.
那么当希拉和提摩太来到的时候，他是被圣灵来感动，要来说。
He said he was led by the Spirit, yeah, or instructed by the Spirit, to preach Jesus is the Christ.
那么他是被圣灵来引导、感动，来传、耶稣是基督。
This is what the early church had been preaching from the very beginning, since her inception.
那么这是早期教会自从创始以来呢，一直在传的。
So even when Paul was moved by the Holy Spirit, you find that he preached the same message, the core belief that they share.
那我们发现说，即使保罗是被圣灵来感动呢，他还是在传他们核心的这个信仰。
So quite clearly, you know, when a person is under the movement of the Holy Spirit, he would not preach, you know, a gospel which is contrary to what he has first received.
那么我们发现说，即使人是被圣灵来感动的，他所传的不会与他起初所领受的来产生冲突。
So if I said I'm moved by the Holy Spirit to preach, and yet my message is different from what I first received, it means that the motivation within is not from the Holy Spirit.
那我若是说我是被圣灵感动，我所传的却不符合我起初所领受的话呢，那就代表说我的动机是不是根据圣灵的。
You know when we talk about the initial faith, I'm talking about the agreed truth that we are preaching now in the church.
那么提到说这起初的信仰呢，就是我们教会里所一致所相信的这个信仰。
It doesn't change, you know, it's not given to change.
那么这是不会改变。
So if we hold firm to that,
那我们要是抓紧这一点
，When we reason with others based on the scriptures, we will be able to unearth many precious teachings to back up our own belief.
那我们若是引用圣经向别人来传道的时候呢，我们就会会得到更加从圣经中得到更多宝贵的教训。
To back up our belief.
来证明我们所传我们的信仰。
To make our belief even clearer than before.
让我们的信仰变得比起初呢更加的清楚。
This is how we should reason with the scriptures.
那这是我们如何要引用圣经来和别人来理论。
Thank God my sermon ends here.
那感谢神呢，我的正道就到此。